When the energy is converted from one form to other, there is always some losses in each stage. Losses while converting chemical energy in fuel to brake power are shown in this layout. Let's discuss some efficiencies or losses associated with the engine. As the time available for combustion is very short, a small fraction of fuel does not burn or react and exits with the exhaust flow. This loss is expressed in combustion efficiency. Combustion efficiency is ratio of mass of fuel burned to mass of fuel inducted and has typical values of around 95% to 98%. Thermal efficiency. It is the ratio of power produced to the energy in the fuel. Neta thermal efficiency is equal to power by m dot f into qf. Indicated thermal efficiency. Neta ith is equal to indicated power by m dot f into qf. Brake thermal efficiency. Brake thermal efficiency is the ratio of brake power by m dot f into qf. Friction losses and pumping losses come under transmission loss. Friction loss is power loss due to friction between components. Pumping loss. In order to draw air from manifold into cylinder, the piston is required to do work against the manifold depression, and this is termed pumping work. Strictly speaking, the work done by the piston is a result of the pressure differential between that of a manifold and the crankcase. Mechanical efficiency. It is the ratio of brake power by indicated power. Mechanical efficiency can also be defined as the ratio of brake thermal efficiency to indicated thermal efficiency. It also follows that neta mechanical efficiency is equal to indicated specific fuel consumption by brake specific fuel consumption. Specific fuel consumption. It is defined as the fuel flow rate per unit power output and can be expressed as SFC is equal to m dot f by p. Brake specific fuel consumption is m dot f by brake power. Indicated specific fuel consumption is m dot f by ip. Specific fuel consumption is a measure of how efficiently the fuel is supplied to the engine is used to produce power. Clearly, low value of SFC is desirable. Let us see brake specific fuel consumption versus engine size. Brake specific fuel consumption generally decreases with engine size due to reduced heat loss from the gas to the cylinder wall. At low speeds, the brake specific fuel consumption increases due to increased time for heat losses from gas to the cylinder and piston. At high speeds, BSFC increases due to increased friction losses. As compression ratio R is increased, fuel consumption decreases due to greater thermal efficiency. Air fuel ratio is the ratio of mass flow rate of air to mass flow rate of fuel. In SI engines, the value ranges from 12 to 18, and in CI engines, the value ranges from 18 to 17. Sometimes it can also be represented as fuel air ratio, that means the reciprocal of these values. Equivalence ratio. Phi is equal to actual fuel air ratio by stoichiometric fuel air ratio. Observe closely that this is not air fuel ratio, this is fuel air ratio. When phi is equal to 1, it is called chemically correct mixture. When phi is less than 1, we call it as a lean mixture. When phi is greater than 1, we call it as a rich mixture. Volumetric efficiency. Volumetric efficiency is defined as volume of air induced to the swept volume of the cylinder. Neta V is equal to MA by rho A into VD. It can also be represented in terms of flow rates, that is, neta V is equal to N into M dot A by rho A into VD into N. N is equal to 2 for 4 stroke engine, N is equal to 1 for 2 stroke engine, where N is revolutions per second. Neta V can also be looked at as actual mass of charge induced by theoretical mass of charge induced. Normally aspirated engine has volumetric efficiency of about 80% and can be increased by supercharging or turbocharging. Let's see delivery ratio and charging efficiency. As there is loss in scavenging period, the term volumetric efficiency as applied to a 4-stroke engine is replaced by terms delivery ratio and charging efficiency in 2-stroke engine, whose formulas and definitions are shown below.